Have you ever seen a haunted house? You know the kind I mean. That old dark house that's usually at the end of a dimly lit street. The owners haven't been seen for years. No one really knows why. The windows are broken and boarded, and the shutters hang loose on their hinges. The trees have grown wild. Their branches brush against the sides of the weathering house, making strange noises in the night. There's a high vine-covered fence around the property. Is it there to keep somebody out? Or is it there to keep something inside? It's a house that people avoid walking past at night. Strange sounds come from within the walls. And it's said that eerie lights have been seen both in the attic windows and in the graveyard at the side of the house. Our story revolves around this mysterious mansion.
When hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls, whenever candlelights flicker, where the air is deathly still, that is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now.
ERTFR!
So we're going to go right to the caller board. 760, you're on the air.
Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
I called you before with the story about the old spot, the mortician.
Oh, right. Hey, how you doing?
Yeah. I got another one that's not quite so scary, but, I grew up kind of a latchkey kid, you know, and we were, there was a period of time where I didn't live too far from not very far, and Disneyland and all that. So, what I used to do, sneak away from home and go to Disneyland, and you used to be able to get into for free to Disneyland, but you had to have tickets to ride each ride.
Oh,
so,
okay.
What I would do is I'd pay to get get into Disneyland, which was a minimal amount, and then just walk around. And that's basically how I spent my time there, and that's very far. And when I was, and I loved Haunted Mansion. I used to go on that ride, or skeet around it, and every chance I got. And it's a shame that they tore it down.
Can you also try to speak up just a little bit? I guess they're having trouble hearing you.
Okay. Anyway, but unfortunately, they tore the Haunted Mansion down and built something over it. When I was there one time, I snuck over the fence. I didn't pay to get in, so I didn't have a band on my arm.
Oh, okay.
And one of the guards caught me and took me into detention area. There was a place for lost kids. And it was right by the tram that goes all the way around the park. Not the tram, the railroad car.
Oh, okay.
There used to be a railroad car that rode all around. And that railroad car would stop at different areas, a couple different places around the park, and if there was a lost kid, they'd get on, and they'd look around for the parents, get on the train.
Yeah, sure.
So they got a hold of either my mom or dad or whatever, and they told him, he has an hour to get his butt home. So they let me go, just give you something to think about. They tore down the Haunted Mansion and a couple other what's that other Pirates of the Caribbean. Walt Disney was a Satanist pedophile. So that would give you something to think up on. Okay?
That is crazy.
Do you have anything to say to that?
Well, I've heard the allegations of Walt Disney being involved in questionable activities. I didn't know that for sure, but I don't know what to say.
I don't know. I think there's more than one reason that why they buried those attractions.
Oh, do you? Okay.
Did that answer?
Sure.
Yeah. All right. I just wanted to throw something out there and give you something to think about. That's something I've been thinking about almost all my life because I was going around there and I seen kids, go in that room, off that ride, and I see parents pick them up. Who knows? Seeing how under the circumstances, I wouldn't surprised if there was something fishy going on there.
Yeah, I know there's a lot of legends and a lot of the stories of nefarious things having gone on in that whole circle, and you're right, you know, it's hard to know, but wow. Well, thank you for your call, sir. I appreciate it.
Okay.
All right.
Good night.
All right. Good night to you. Thank you for calling. Wow. Yeah, I don't know what to say. It's one of those things that I just don't know what to say to. Yeah, there could be, you know, real deep reasons why they would bury that stuff. And you know, I think it's one of those things that I just don't know if I'd want to know. You know, because you just can't unhear things. You know, once you find out things, you just can't unhear them. So, But anyway, thank you for calling in. I do appreciate it. And please, anybody else call in. I'm glad to hear your stories and glad to hear your thoughts on things. And it's what this show is all about. So I appreciate that. Before the break, we were talking about mirrors, and I was going into a bit of a story of how they were used in at least one practice. And it's actually a practice that continues to this day. It's, you know, I don't know, I've not heard of anybody having a negative effect from it, but I know that anytime there are those that say any ritual, of course, is dangerous, but what the practice is essentially is to sit in front of a mirror in a darkened room with either a 5-watt bulb burning behind you or a candle or something of that effect, and then just relax with relaxing music on and just focus. And people have encountered, or at least claim to have encountered, deceased relatives, had long conversations with people that have passed on, and very healing conversations. So it sounds like it could be a really positive thing. But again, I don't ever want to have the impression of this show that I'm somehow advocating people to start messing with things that they don't understand or aren't comfortable with. But I don't want to, you know, to be, for that to be what the show is about. In fact, I had to whittle out a whole bunch of information for things that I could have covered tonight, just because I don't want this to be, you know, a springboard into practices that people can't handle. So I'm glad to give information. I'm glad to talk about phenomenon and experiences, but I never want to guide people in any way. That's not what the show is about. It's just about discussing phenomenon that's not normal. It's not a part of our everyday world, even though it is, you know what I'm saying. But it's about discussing thoughts and possibilities and rediscovering the mystery. And that's what this is about. So what I did want to read, though, and I'm not going to name the site because it's
Hurry back. Be sure to bring your death certificate if you decide to join us. Make final arrangements now. We've been dying to have you.